These beauties are Daiwa's new Matchman method feeder rods. They're as cheap as chips. There's three rods in the range, 10 foot, 11 foot and 12 foot, and they're clearly designed to be used with a method feeder. But are they anything more than one trick ponies? Well, let's find that out. So we started the session off with, actually we used quite a big feeder, which was that, which when it's full of ground bait, probably weighs a good 60 grams, I would have thought. And even though we're not fishing particularly far out, it's far enough for good test, and certainly far enough that the sort of angler that would want this rod would use. And very first cast, after we put in half a dozen feeder falls, we've had a fish, almost certainly, I think, a skimmer. But it's what I was after, really, because you can see whether the rod is a little bit too stiff for silvers, but I'm not unhappy. It's a progressive action, as you would expect from a modern day feeder rod, especially with a method feeder tag. But it's a nice enough skimmer, and we're only fishing with a 14 hook and quite a light line, but I haven't felt like it's going to rip the hook out of it. And there's the first fish of the day. Really nice looking fresh skimmer. Impressive. Three casts, three fish, another skimmer, all like peas in a pod at the moment, but good signs. We haven't lost a single fish yet, so we're not unhappy with this rod's action, even though it does carry that method tag. That one's a little bit smaller, but it is all action at the moment. But I will try and explain how a rod that was designed, let's say, for method feeder fishing can be used for this, and what would be the difference between a method feeder rod and a normal rod, feed rod that you would use to go silverfish fishing with. But let's be honest, if you're looking at a rod like this and the price of them, which really is cheap as chips, why wouldn't you want a rod that's got a bit more versatility? It makes perfect sense to me. Now, the old adage that you very often hear in association with any bream fishing is, you should sit on your hands. Sit on your hands when you get a bite, sit on your hands. And I'll tell you where that comes from. It comes because big bream, especially big bream, not so much skimmers, when they feed, they invert like this, and they are not touching the bait when they feed. There they are. There's a case of a point. I picked that up too early. So they invert, so they stand on their heads, and they've got very, very long lips. They extend the lips, and they probably suck in the really big ones, probably sucking the bait in from about a good 4 inches. Now, I've seen that happen because I used to live on the River Gipping and the water's very clear, and I watched them feed and was absolutely amazed to see the fish come along, stand up like that, but they're off of the bottom. You think they're just going across the bottom with their mouths, and not. They're like that far off the bottom. So when they say, oh, you should sit on your hands when you get a bite, it's because when they pick that bait up and suck it in, the tip's going to go around like that. And you think, okay, that's on. What you need to do is just wait till it goes right the way round, and it's impossible for it not to be hooked. Then obviously you don't strike, just pick the rod up. But why you have to do that with bream is because I noted when watching the fish in the bit of river outside my house, there was a two-tone, and it happens with bream, there's a two-tone fish, which is basically one half of it was dark, the other half was light. So it was easy to see it in about 4 foot of water. And it was almost a lead fish. Wherever that fish went, all the other bream followed it round. So if that's the first fish that arrives to your bait, and then it inverts the feed, and you spook it by picking it up early or pricking it or something like that, or even begin a bit overexcited and snapping off, that's it, you're done. You know, the fish will probably move on in a match situation. Maybe they'll move off a little bit and the next guy might catch you, and you've had the fish in front of you, but you've made a mess of it. So that sitting on your hands is a really good way for looking at the tip when you're bream fishing. There's the bite, just wait until the tip goes around and stays around. They're not gonna break your line, they're not gonna take the rod in, just sit there until it's absolutely conclusive that the fish is hooked. That way, should you sure that you have a better day because the fish will stay with you, and that all the fish that you hook are hooked properly. Now bream, you can deep hook them, but if you don't have too long a hook length, that shouldn't happen too much. Is when you have a really long hook length and all that happens and they've sucked it right the way down before the rod's properly gone round. But if you start with sort of 18 inches to 2 foot before you do a really long tail. You shouldn't have too many problems with deep hooking. Anyway, let's have another cast and see if I can actually catch a bigger fish. Oh, not like that one. Whilst we're waiting between bites, and we've just had a little touch there, but I'll explain something else that you'll see when you're fishing for bream and skimmers that you don't see at a commercial so often. And it's that rod rest. That's a Daiwa detached rod rest. And they're that little bit longer. You don't necessarily need it for method feeder fishing, but unless you use it right on the end. Now look, there's a sit on your hands bit coming. And that's definitely on and we're in. But the idea of that is, when I said to you like about making sure the line's tight to the feeder, but without moving the feeder, you can move the rod along the rod rest in tiny increments without having to use the reel. So having a wider rod rest helps you with that, because you know, every cast isn't exactly the same. None of us are, you know, are that good. We like to think we are, but we're not. And the wind can catch the feeder and, you know, the line can go a little bit different. You hit the clip a little bit harder, or, you know, so moving the rod, you know, a little bit, you know, as you can see in those grooves there, helps with that. And that's why very often on natural venues, you'll see people using wider rod rests. You definitely need a flat one rather than a U one as well, because you can't do that in a U type rod rest. But good investment if you're going, you know, fishing natural venues for bream and skimmers. That is an absolute must, and that's a really nice one. Lots of manufacturers do them, but that one's quite nice, and it's one of the cheaper ones on the market. Definitely a better fish. You know, with a bream one, it's slightly better because you feel them, they nod. They, you know, you can feel their head slamming or they go like that, you know. And a carp, you know, barbel boar and carp run around, but big bream do that. They bang their heads from side to side, you know, they're trying to get rid of the hook, you know. They're not noted fighters, but they are, you know, they are. Look at that, that's a beautiful bream, look. That's a much better fish. Look at that, cracker. Not quite a slab, but, you know, certainly a bream more than a skimmer. There's no industry standard in fishing for the difference between bream and skimmers that I know of. It's just that skimmers, you know, I suppose the word comes from, you can skim them across the top, I'm not sure, but that one you're not skimming anywhere across the top, because that's probably getting on for 2.5-3 pound. Now, at the start of the piece, I said I'd explain a little bit about the differences between a rod like this, which is a very modern method feeder rod, and what would be an old school sort of classic feeder rod. Now, this is a two-piece blank. It's made of a high modulus carbon, no problem with that, but it's got a progressive action, both in its fish playing and its casting abilities. And that is ideal for dealing with carp and method feeders, but not always ideal for bream, which can be a bit, and skimmers, it can be a little bit tricky to get out. But as you can see, it's quite soft on the top and you can just about get away with it. In fact, we're more than getting away with it. It's really good. Now, if this was a rod that was designed just to catch them or bream or roach and that sort of thing, it would almost certainly have a three-piece build. And the top section, the carrier section as it's known, which carries a quiver tip, would be quite soft. The next section a little bit firmer, and the butt section would be firmer still. And why it's designed like that is it gives you more casting ability at the bottom end of the rod, but a really nice soft top section. There's quite a difficult rod to design to get it perfect, but basically that's the difference between a 12 foot old school classic feeder rod and a very modern two-piece method feeder rod. So it all got a bit slow, and we've had a bit of a change around, and it's sort of the end of the day anyway, so I thought I'd put a method on just to see, just to make sure it would cast it straight, which it's certainly done. I've put an elasticated method on because I've fishing it a little bit more range, but there we are, that's a little skimmer. And I've had a good few hours with the rod. In fact, I've had a great day, I've had loads of fish. And what I would say about this rod is this. besides the fact it's a very good bargain, and if you're looking for a sort of an all-round feeder rod at a budget price, then you're not going to go far wrong. What it will do is you can fish at a commercial with it, no problem, method feeders. You can certainly fish a natural venue like this for skimmers and bream, tench. You could even flirt with it down the river for chub and barbel. What you can't do with it is cast huge distances. It's not a casting rod, it's not going to happen. And I wouldn't fancy it at all for sort of roach and lighter lines and really small hooks, say under 16. It's not, the action isn't quite light enough for that. But it certainly has got plenty of flexibility when it comes to its tactical uses, certainly more than just method feeder fishing. And if you wanted some proof that Daiwa's new Matchman method feeder rods are more than a one-trick pony and have certainly got more than one string to their bow, then here's the proof. Not bad for a commercial method feeder rod.